So dear students, in our last section we have seen the distance based machine learning methods, and now we will see KNN, that is nothing but K nearest neighbor. So for understanding the KNN concept, we can take this simple example that tell me about your friends or who your neighbors are, and I will tell you who you are. Means if I will ask a person that tell me about your friends and neighbors, so by considering these person's features, I can predict what can be the person's features are, because he can possess the same features that the person who are surrounded who are surrounded by him will have. So that is nothing but KNN, that the persons who are related to the person, they all are having the same features, and that is nothing but KNN is, means instance based learning. Here we also can see that this particular person is trying to access the things. Now he is having the phone, he is having the computer, he is having laptop, palm top, everything. So this instance based learning means he is thinking that it's all are similar to desktop, and definitely they are all similar to desktop, means they are having the same features, same attributes, and that's why they are classified into the desktop class. So the desktop having all these neighbors, where computer is there, your telephone is there, your palm top, laptop is there, that's the funda related to KNN. Actually KNN is also known as memory based reasoning, example based reasoning, instance based learning, as well as lazy learning. Now why it is called as lazy learning? Because by considering the various attributes which are similar, we can predict the things, and that's why the time complexity is less about KNN. So what is KNN? It is a powerful classification algorithm which is used in the pattern recognition. This is very necessary that it is used in the pattern recognition. It stores all available cases and classifies new cases based on the similarity measure. Similarity we have seen in our last section under the distance based learning. So K nearest neighbors do what? It stores all the available cases and classifies the new cases, and these classification of new cases is done by the pattern recognition or by doing the similarity measure of the already available cases. So we can say that this is one of the top data mining algorithm which is used today at a large level, and a non-parametric lazy algorithm also. As I said, why it is called as lazy algorithm? Actually it is one of the introductory supervised classifier. So to be supervised classifier, K nearest neighbor classifier mostly represented as KNN. So it whenever we are thinking or talking about KNN, it always addresses the pattern recognition problems. The simple version of KNN is to predict the target label by finding the nearest neighbor class, and the closest class will be identified using the distance measure, that is nothing but Euclidean distance, which we have seen in our last section. So the KNN algorithm is a pattern recognition model that is used for classification as well as regression both. So we can see the classification approach over here, that is an object is classified by majority votes for its neighbor class. Means we can see over here, the object is assigned to a common class among its k nearest neighbors, and it's measured by the distance functions, and it is classified by the maximum votes for its neighbor class. Okay, so in pattern recognition, actually KNN is responsible for classifying the object based on close training examples. It is type of instance based learning or lazy learning, where the function is only approximated locally and all computation is done under the classification. So as I said, the function is approximated at local level and the classification is done, and that's why KNN is very simple classification technique, because there is little or no prior knowledge about distribution of data. Only we are having the some cases, and by using that cases we are predicting the new cases. So the nearest neighbor rule is simplest from KNN when k is equal to 1. In this method, in this way the classification can be done. So whenever k is equal to 1, the nearest rule can be simple. In this method, each sample should be classified similar to its surrounding by the surrounding samples, and therefore the classification of sample is unknown. Because why it is unknown? Because we are predicting it by its nearest neighbor samples. So whenever we are having unknown sample and training set, then the distance between the unknown sample and all the samples can be computed. So as we can see over here, the distance plays the main role, because whenever we are having the unknown sample, we can count or consider the distance between unknown sample and all the samples that we are having in the training set. As we can see, these are the training records and this is the test record. So what we are doing, we are computing the distance, and this particular is object which we are testing. So this particular object, we will choose the nearest object which is nearest to this particular object, and we will choose it by computing the distance, and the distance should be as low, as less as possible. And that's why the testing is done by matching or comparing the distance from the nearest record. And the record will be, we can see over here, the records are of same class according to the object. So that's why distance measure is plays the important role, because it is the smallest value which corresponds to the sample in the training set, so that we can find out the closest sample to the particular object. So these are the various distance measures for continuous variables. This we have already seen in our last sections. So for this distance measure in KNN, Euclidean, Manhattan or Minkowski distance measures are used. So the distance between the neighbors are calculated by the Euclidean distance, that is d of xy is equal to square root of summation of I is equal to 1 to n xi minus yi square, which is nothing but our Euclidean distance, which we have seen in our last section. So in k nearest neighbor algorithm, all the instances corresponds to the points in n dimensional feature space. So this was the distance which we have covered. Now in our next section, we will see the KNN algorithm, the regression for that KNN, nearest neighbor predictions, and the advantages, limitations and applications. Today in this section, we have seen what is KNN, why KNN is used for the classification, and how the distance measure is used for the classification. Thank you.